Moms who know do less so they can focus on what matters most, taking care of themselves, their families, and living their God-given purpose. Moms who know focus on the little things they can do that grow to have a huge impact. You are connecting with your family, your true self, and your God-given purpose. You are a mom who knows. Hello and welcome to the Moms Who Know podcast. Thank you for joining me for this One Little Thing episode. Today we are going to talk about finding joy in the motherhood journey. And before I get started with that, I wanted to just share a recent review. I'm so grateful when you guys leave reviews. This one was from Amanda Gold. She says this: "What a fantastic podcast. It is always well thought out and delivered, and I always leave feeling uplifted. Chanel is a great host, and you can tell she puts a lot of time and thought into her content. I'm always impressed with her interview skills. She also has awesome content on Facebook and Instagram and just really shows up for her community." Thank you so much for that. That's so nice to hear, and I love it. And some of you are watching it. You may know these bonus episodes I actually do as a Facebook Live. So some of you watch these on Facebook Live. And if you're not there, come and join the party. You can also listen to these on the podcast if you ever miss one and want to go back and listen on the podcast. So today we're talking about finding joy in the motherhood journey. And this is a really relevant topic for my day. So my kids are home from school for the break. And because they're home, it's been really hard for Carter, who's my 3-year-old, to take his naps. He wants to be where the kids are, and he's also getting just a little bit older, and he realizes that nap time is not as much fun as he used to think it was, and he doesn't want to go and take a nap all the time. And so it's become just this battle of putting him to bed and him getting out and putting him to bed over and over and over. And as I was doing that today, it was getting a little frustrating. I put him to bed a bunch of times. And then finally I said, okay, do you want to come lay in my bed with me? And just for the record, if I don't put him down for a nap, if he skips his nap, it's not like he's just happy and he doesn't need it. He gets cranky. He falls asleep in the evening. It just causes all sorts of problems. And so he definitely is still at that age where he needs his nap, but he's fighting it. So I brought him in my room and we laid down together so that he could take a nap. And I was feeling a little bit frustrated. And then he started singing this cute little song that we know from the library. And it just was so sweet. And all of a sudden, I just was so grateful that I was there in that moment, snuggling him, listening to him sing, and having this little moment with him that I wouldn't have had if he had just gone to bed the way he was supposed to. And so I got to thinking about finding joy in the little moments, because I feel like as moms, that's really where the joy is. It's in the small things. It's in these tiny moments. So much of our motherhood is stressful. It's hard. It can be overwhelming at times. We feel like we have so many things to do and so many balls to juggle and all these things going on that it can sort of feel like it's stealing away the joy. I actually read this quote by a researcher. She said, "There is joy to having kids, but I think that for most people, the stresses that are associated with having kids overshadow those joys." And when I read that, I felt so sad. That just makes me feel so sad, because I think there are a lot of parents out there who their stress really is overshadowing the joy of parenting. And I talk to moms all the time who just feel overwhelmed, who at the end of the day are tired and they feel burdened, and maybe they're not feeling the joy of parenting. And we want to feel that every day. So I want to talk about a couple of ways, things that we can do to feel joy and to find the joy in the journey, and really to find that joy every single day. And I love the phrase, find joy in the journey, because what it says to me is the joy isn't in the destination. It's not like, oh, when your kid hits a certain age, or when they go to high school, or when they leave the house, or when something happens, that's when the joy is. The joy is all along the way. And actually, Dieter F. Uchtdorf has a quote about that. He says, "Happiness is the destination, but it's also the path." So yeah, It's all those big things. It's all those moments. It's all those milestones, but it's also the path. It's the little things every single day and those little moments along the path. So some daily habits that can help us with happiness and joy. First, do things every day that matter to you, because what can end up happening is we get so busy and we're running around and we're doing things and we're productive and we're efficient, we're crossing things off of our to-do list. But if we aren't focusing on the right things, the things that really matter to us, then all we have at the end of the day is a list of things we've done that don't really bring us joy. So what are the things that matter to you? What are the things that are going to bring you joy in the long run? For a lot of us, it's the things we talk about over and over. It is focusing on taking care of our families, taking care of ourselves, and living our God-given purpose. When we get those things right, when we're doing those every single day, then the little things that don't matter as much, our toddler not taking a nap, our big kids being mad at us, that also happened today. Those things, we can kind of let them go because we have a bigger picture of where we're headed. We know what we're trying to do. We know that even though our teenagers are mad at us because they can't have all the phone time that they want, we have their greater good in mind. And we are building this relationship with them. We are teaching them even when it's the hard thing to do. Number two, way to find joy and happiness is to really be present in the little moments and focus on the joy and the gratitude of tiny moments. So that experience I shared earlier with Carter, just hearing him sing, we have those moments all day long, but are we taking the time to feel grateful for them and to kind of soak them in, live it, hear it, and not just like, oh, that's cute, I wish he was asleep, right? We want to hear it and think, oh, I am so grateful for this moment. I am so appreciative that I am here hearing this song right now, snuggling with my three-year-old, feeling the softness of his skin. Just really being in that moment allows that to sink in. And that's what kind of creates that memory. Someday our kids are going to grow up and they're going to be gone. And all we're going to have is those memories. So moms, don't pass it all by. Don't be in such a hurry for the next thing, for the big moment, thinking that's the joy, that's the happiness. The little things are the happiness. Even when it's hard, even when it's stressful, I promise if you look for them, those moments are there. That is my brief one little thing message for you today. Find joy in the journey. And next week, next Monday on the podcast, we are going to talk about body positivity. This was a request over in the Facebook group. So know that I love your requests. I love when you guys have ideas for the podcast. Feel free to reach out with ideas. Definitely, if this episode meant something to you, if it uplifted your day, if you got something from it, share this with a friend, leave a review. Those things mean so much to me. Thank you for being here. And as always, thank you for listening to Moms Who Know.